Hello, welcome to Liberica Bar. Today we are talking about wonderful news, new JEP of BellSoft production, that number is 386, is proposed target. And Dmitry Chuyko, performance engineer of BellSoft, today will tell us about this JEP, about the background of this JEP, some demands, ideas, and so on. So, hi Dmitry, nice to see you. So, Dmitry, let's discuss the BellSoft preparation for the final changes to upstream the Alpine Linux port to OpenJDK, and we should tell our subscribers what JEP is and what our JEP is about.
Okay, so it would be right to start the brief history of Project Portola. What is it about?
Let's start from what JEP is.
Okay.
To understand the new
JEP is about integration of Project Portola code into mainline of JDK, which will bring one more port of OpenJDK, a hotspot, which is a port to Alpine muscle Linux. To a Linux that has, to any Linux distribution that has muscle library as a standard C library, not glibc. That's the technical difference. And such Linux distributions typically use this muscle library to reduce static footprint, to reduce the size of the installation of this Linux. And the difference is like, you, in case of Alpine Linux, for example, you reduce the size of that installation from like 30 megabytes to like 5,
cool,
which is very impressive.
Mm-hmm.
And it finds applications in two areas, I would say. Of course, some small devices that need to save some space on their disks or cards or whatever, and in clouds where you need to save costs that are related to your containers. So in a container you need OS layer that provides you like basic functionality. If we talk about Java, and we make calls to libraries that find that layer, and it makes sometimes no sense to keep it too bloated, because if you have a small OS layer, it is cheaper to provision new instance in a cloud or to upgrade existing service, because you spend less wall clock time, you spend less network traffic and CPU time and disk space. Disk space is relatively cheap, but when you save most of network traffic in this process, you have cheaper and faster deployment, which we all like.
Yeah, really, it can maximize your business value.
Yes.
The main idea is less is more. Yeah, well, okay, that's quite cost efficiency and very interesting for the audience, but how does it connect with Alpine Linux and with the new JEP?
Yeah, as I said, such Linux distributions, they use a different standard library, which means regular build of JDK won't work there. So we need a special build, and it should be, again, tested, TCK verified, because we are like truly tested and compliant assemblies. And it is kind of technical work, technical addition to OpenJDK. And it's been developed in Project Portola. There's a special OpenJDK project to support muscle C library in OpenJDK. It has been started by Michael Wittstedt from Oracle. And Our job is about making it a part of mainline JDK, which will make current code kind of standard in mainline JDK, and also we pay attention to correctness. So we don't just think about what currently BellSoft or other company provides in terms of Project Portola and related builds, assemblies of OpenJDK, because you may now get such builds. They work. You can get container images, diff Alpine muscle Linux. But everyone do it maybe slightly differently. And there are circumstances then something may not work as expected. So this work is to make this project production ready for everyone. And finally, it must be integrated, supported in mainline OpenJDK.
Dmitry, and could you please explain me why did Oracle and Michael didn't continue to work with this dev, because they started to do it, but finally no one just didn't systemize all this information.
Well, it was kind of a side project.
So just as initiative of Michael.
Yes, yes. But there's a lot of technical work.
Well, okay, and talking about their values of this job, what would people have working with this job, and how it can make their life easily?
Well, I think users really start to realize benefits of this port from the very beginning, because we see that Alpine glibc and Alpine muscle are the most popular downloads if we talk about container images. That means that, yeah, people do need smaller containers. And that's...
Yes, that's all,
yeah,
all
it's a kind of optimization that you can get for free. Mm-hmm. You can just change the line for your Docker from or pull. Mm-hmm. And you have some optimization. There's no, almost no cost, because yeah, of course you have to test what you got, and we saw few scenarios. Then you have to be careful then you use it, and I will have a talk about that this year. I will talk about this chap and how what would benefits it brings in terms of cost savings, and what technical peculiarities are there. So, yeah.
So you're preparing something like a
big
speech?
Yes, we'll discuss that in more detail.
Okay, and where will we find it? We should be in some conferences?
Yeah, some conferences, mm-hmm. YouTube videos.
Okay, I think it will be interesting, and we will send for our followers and subscribers all the information about Dmitry conferences.
Yes. I think the easiest way is to subscribe to our blog or our YouTube channel. And mm-hmm.
Okay, Dmitry, and could you tell me, were there any demands or any problems when you're working with Jeff? Maybe some technical details or that was... That was hard to do.
Well, it was funny in my mailbox mail thread about this chap just went far to the right. So there were quite long discussions on relatively tiny changes. We just need to make it clean. And sometimes interesting scenarios appear not just for Alpine muscle, but also in different operating systems that have behavior not typical to what we work with daily, like it happened in AIX. But that's all working moments, and they just fixed them.
Okay, I got it. And could you please tell what is the next for BellSoft in this area? What could you do? Could you do more?
Yeah, what's interesting is then we integrate that into mainline. We lower the complexity of maintenance, which means we can bring support, for example, for more versions of Java, the Alpine muscle, more platforms. Like Jeff has been proposed to target, and it's already mentioned that there will be support for AR64, which wasn't initially there. And currently, we provide images with Alpine muscle for JDK 8. So as you may understand, ongoing development is based on JDK 16 at base, but we provide images for current release, for 11 and for 8 now, which means, yeah, a lot of people still use latest JDK 8 updates, I hope latest updates, and yes, you can get small container with JDK 8 that has container support. Please see my talk about that. If you get the latest and greatest update of JDK 8, you get a lot of features that weren't initially in JDK 8. And finally, you have not only container support, but also small container with 8, which is great.
And if you're talking about some old versions like 6 or 7, could we find it there?
Yeah, JDK 6 was small, but I don't think you really need to use that in production nowadays.
Okay, I got it. So I think that's all about JEP. There are there other details I will probably will hear in your speech in the conferences. And what is more, BellSoft created a new article about this JEP, and you could read the details and technical information in this article on BellSoft blog. Dmitry was writing this article. As far as I remember. And what is more, you can subscribe on newsletter, BellSoft newsletter, and to find out more information about JEP and some other interesting things like GVM, mission control, and some interesting tools that guys are creating for you. Well, thank you, Dmitry. Hope to see you again.
Thank you.
Well, for the next episode of Liberica Bar, we will prepare the new theme about microservices. I think it will be an awesome discussion with our technical specialist and maybe with Alexander Belakrylov, the CEO of BellSoft. We will tell you about how you can use microservices and what is the main idea of working with them and how they can help you too. So see you in the next episode of Liberica Bar. Thank you.